बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम अस्सलामुअलैकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज़ द ग्रेविटेशन। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ग्रेविटी। ऑल ऑफ यू आर फेमिलियर विद हु डिस्कवर्ड ग्रेविटी। इट वॉज एक्सीडेंटली डिस्कवर्ड बाई सर आइजक न्यूटन। ही वॉज एट दैट टाइम ही वॉज थिंकिंग अबाउट वन मिस्टीरियस फोर्स दैट वाई प्लैनेट्स रिवॉल्व अराउंड द सन एंड मून रिवॉल्व अराउंड द अर्थ, विच फोर्स इज बेसिकली रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कीप दैम इन देयर ऑर्बिट्स। एट दैट टाइम सडनली ही वॉज सिटिंग अंडर द ट्री एंड एप्पल फॉल ऑन हिज हेड। देन ही वॉज थिंकिंग अबाउट वाई एप्पल फॉल due to its weight, and then accidentally he discovered gravity. In this chapter we will related all the articles related to the gravity. Now today we are going to first discover the law of gravitation. In the law of gravitation by Sir Isaac Newton, it was the same force which is responsible to keep the moon in its orbit and the apple fall down due to its weight. Both were the similar forces. And in universe, every body attracts other body. It has the force of attraction to other bodies. So for this purpose, for this one, now we are starting from here. We have the two masses, M1 and M2 mass, and M1 mass and M2 mass, and they are separated with the distance d. Now exerting a force M2 on M2, and same way M2 is also exerting the force on mass M1. Now then both are attracting to each towards each other. Now they are separated with the distance. Now the force is basically the directly proportional to their product of their masses. If the product of masses is greater, then its mean force is also the greater, and if the product of masses is less, then force is also less. So it undergoes the direct relation with the product of their masses. So we will write down over here, it's the first equation. This is the first equation, F directly proportional to M1 and M2. Now, second one is that, what about their distance? Now, suppose that we have the two bodies, this one, and it is that they are separated with the distance D. And second one, we are increasing the distance, two bodies, bodies are the same one, and now we are increasing the distance. Then what would be happened? Now, if the distance is less, then the force of attraction among these two bodies are the greater one. And if we are increasing the distance, it's mean the force of attraction between these two bodies is decreasing. So it's mean when distance is increasing, force is reducing, and when distance is decreasing, force is increasing. It's mean it's undergo the, this force is undergoes the inverse relation with the square of the distance between these two bodies. Now this is equation 2. Force is that undergoes the inverse relation with the square of the distance between these two bodies. Now we will combine these two equations, equation 1 and equation 2. Now F, M1, M2 and D square. Now what we will do? We will remove the proportionality sign and we will put the G. G is the gravitational constant. M1, M2, D square, it is the law of gravitation. It's a formula. Product of the masses divided by d square and g. Now g is a gravitational constant. Then next what we will do, we will find out the units of the g. We will use the same formula, we will separate the g, we will do the cross multiplication. The formula will be the alter f d square by m1 m2, and we will put the units. Unit of f is n, and the unit of distance is meter. Over here d square, so meter square, kilogram, so it would be newton meter square per kilogram square. Now, unit of the G is newton meter square per kilogram square, or newton meter square. We can write down in this way or in this way. Those are both are the units of G. Now, value of the G, it's a constant, and its value is 6.673 into 10 raised to minus 11. Now, its a value is a very, very small. That's why in our surrounding, we can't feel the attraction of the some objects. Why? The reason is that due to the small value of the G. And keep in one thing, the value of the G is every place, every point, it would be the same. It would be the 6.673 into 10 raised to minus 11. It would not be changed. Now, this law of the gravitation is also have the Newton third law of motion, consistency of the Newton third law of motion. How? Because when this mass is applying the force on it and this mass is applying the force on it, now both have the forces are same in equal in magnitude but opposite in a direction. So it also have the consistency with the Newton third law of motion.